Good evening. We start tonight with breaking news. Opposition leader Peter Dutton has just landed in Israel for a three-day trip. As we go to air, Dutton is currently meeting with Israeli Foreign Minister Israel Katz. He will then, later today, local time, meet with Israeli President Isaac Herzog. This is a strong show of support from the coalition towards our closest ally in the Middle East. It comes as senior figures in the Israeli government are growing increasingly frustrated with the Albanese government's public criticisms and hostilities. I can also reveal the opposition leader will then meet with hostage families and former hostages who have now been rescued by Israel. These will be deeply emotional meetings for Peter Dutton. You hardly ever hear our current government speak about the hostages, yet there are still 120 Israelis, including baby Kefia Bibas, held captive by terrorists in Gaza. Dutton will also, over the coming days, travel to the south, to the kibbutzes, where Hamas slaughtered entire families. And he'll go to the site of the Nova Music Festival, where 1,200 young Israelis were gunned down in cold blood. Dutton is unlikely to meet with Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who broke his trip to the US to deal with the escalating situation in the north of Israel. There are concerns war is imminent after the tragic and atrocious attack by Hezbollah on children over the weekend. Now, Peter Dutton is the most senior Australian politician to visit since October 7, with Anthony Albanese refusing to go. Albanese is one of the only Western leaders who chose not to visit Israel to show his support over the past 9 months. And when Penny Wong eventually visited the region, she didn't bother to go to the sites of the October 7 massacres. This trip is highly significant. It reinforces Dutton's commitment to Israel, Australia's ally, and to the Jewish community. It's a volatile situation at the moment on the ground. Already flights are being cancelled to Lebanon amid the tensions with Hezbollah. And we'll cross live to Israeli politician Sharon Haskell later this hour to speak about how she expects the situation is going to unfold in the north. But Dutton's decision to make a solidarity trip to Israel is a sign of how different foreign relations would be under a Dutton prime ministership. And it highlights the leadership we've been sorely missing from the Albanese government.